So, you, Curb Stomped, are a notorious Swiftie.
Am I?
I've heard that you're a notorious Swiftie.
Who told you that?
You're listening to Taylor Swift all day long.
Who told you that?
You even are standing in line for the tickets.
Who She's told you these Vancouver. Lies? She is?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Next year.
Crazy. That's crazy.
Yeah. First.
She's coming here, though?
No, not here. Vancouver.
No, I know, but I was saying, is she coming here, too?
Not here. Vancouver.
Play the Sagebrush Theater.
Right?
Imagine how much the tickets would have to cost. Like 10 grand each? 30 grand each?
Oh, it'd be ridiculous. Man. So,
yeah.
On the weekend that she, or whatever day she's playing, I think she's doing a couple shows.
Probably.
Every hotel in Vancouver sold out.
Oh, yeah.
Tickets aren't even on sale yet.
They're just pre-booked in case they got...
pre-booked.
In case they're getting a ticket?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know who told you these slanderous lies about me, but I'm not a Swiftie. I could name zero Taylor Swift songs.
Yeah?
I would know one if I heard it, but I don't know the names of them.
You could just string a couple words together that's probably a Taylor Swift song.
Well, what's the one where she talks about her boyfriend?
Hey, everyone.
Oh, okay. No, the one where she says Romeo said, I know that one.
No, oh, I don't know.
I don't know what it's called, though. Anyways, what this is about is... record labels are now okay. So the bit of the story here is, well, the article is from Billboard. Thank you to Pixacat for these articles here, by the way. She wrangled them for us. So Taylor Swift recorded her first album, but she doesn't own the masters to it. As most record labels, they own the rights to the songs when they sign you to the contract. That's just the way the record labels have worked in eternity, basically. Screw the artist over.
Yeah, yeah. You record a song for record label, that you don't own that song.
Yeah.
You have no permission.
And you don't really make money on the album. You make money on the tour.
Yeah.
That's where you make the money as the artist. The record label pays to record it and promote it and whatever. And you owe the record label the that amount of money for all that. So any money you make at the start goes to paying that back. And then when you sell more records, you'll eventually get money. Anyways, she didn't own the rights to it. So when these songs would be...
Yeah, first, I don't know how many albums it was. It was the first couple.
Well, whatever her contract says, yeah, right? Yeah. So now she owns everything she does. But she wasn't getting paid anything for these songs. And the way the music industry works, it's so archaic. I don't know. Well, you would probably know, but... That's why Spotify pays the artists like nothing, is because the way the law was set up in like the 1800s, and it was based off of like the autoplay pianos that would you put the roll in and it would be like and play like to duplicate one of those, the royalty to the creator was like a penny. And that's what the Spotify and all these things are based off of, this old law.
Yeah.
Because it was never updated.
Yeah.
They just were like, that law applies to MP3s and streams. It's fine.
Yeah, yeah. 100 years later, so it's they
don't,
insane.
They don't get paid anything. The other thing, too, is like, if you hear Taylor Swift's song in a movie or whatever, they've paid the record label to have the song.
Yeah.
Where they didn't pay Taylor Swift. So she re-recorded her album, new versions. So she owns them. She doesn't own the... song, because the record label does.
Yeah.
But because she recreated them, she only has to pay them a smaller fee, but they can license from her and she can put them on Spotify and then she gets all the money or whatever.
Yeah.
And now, because of the success of this, because it's a little different with Taylor Swift, because she's Taylor Swift and her fans are...
She's one of the biggest recording artists, music artists out there right now. Yeah.
Or of all time. And her fans are like rabid. So
yes.
She could fart into a tube and people would buy a Blu-ray recording of it. But she re-released them and then she gets all the sales. And now it's all about her new version rather than the old version.
Yeah.
So now the record labels want to prevent this from happening. So as they're signing new artists, they're putting a provision in it saying like, oh, you can't re-record these songs at a later date, for a longer period or forever.
Yeah.
Basically, which is another way to screw over artists. I don't know at this point why you would ever sign with a record label.
I don't know why either.
Like, are they not just obsolete now?
I would imagine that there's still benefit with it because you can get your They can get your tunes onto the radio, into movies, and promote you a lot more than now, what you could doing on Spotify or through YouTube or any of that. But, I mean, like just with Justin Bieber, he blew up on YouTube, right?
Yeah.
So it's still an opportunity.
But he's still signed to a record
label.
But that was also, I don't know how long, 15 years ago.
Yeah, that was quite a long time
ago. It was a little different back then.
Yeah. There are streaming has been a huge boon for new artists, but it's also, you know, you don't get paid enough. That's for sure.
Well, that's just like selling a CD though, or whatever, and download on iTunes.
Yeah.
You get the record label takes the money basically. But the other thing too, is you don't have to let your music be on Spotify. Spotify just doesn't have a carte blanche to be like, oh, every song is on Spotify.
Yeah, yeah.
They still have to get you to say, yeah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which Taylor Swift said no.
Yeah. Her
music's not on Spotify. But because of the way the music licensing work, there's all sorts of covers of Taylor Swift. So like there'd be like a woman doing a cover of a Taylor Swift song on Spotify, which is allowed.
Yeah.
Yeah, the music industry kind of was created to screw over the artists basically from day one.
Oh, Taylor Swift's on Spotify.
Oh, she might be back now, but she wasn't. She didn't have her songs on there.
106 million monthly listeners.
There was a lot of people that removed their songs off Spotify too because they wouldn't take Joe Rogan off of Spotify too. Like, I don't think Neil Young is available on Spotify anymore.
Hmm.
Anyways,
Taylor Swift's most popular song on Spotify, 1.3 billion plays.
And that is what?
Cruel Summer.
Like a cover of Cruel Summer? It's
probably a cover of Cruel Summer.
No.
Which is...
No, it's got to be a different one.
100% listen to that later. See if it is.
I saw that there was people trying to buy the first pressing of her first album because there's like a homophobic line that they changed. She said something about you're being so gay or something like that.
And just being sappy.
Something... No, that's not the way it was in the song. I can't remember exactly what it is. I see it on TikTok anyways. Yeah. It's interesting that they're trying to do this to screw over artists even more. But like, it's like, I don't know. Like any of these artists now that you hear coming up, are they signed to a major label? I don't know.
I don't know either.
Like, is Ice Spice signed to a major label?
I don't know.
The only
label I listen to on a regular basis, like artists off that label, and that's primarily my listening choices, is, of course, Monster Cat.
Yeah, but I think that one's a little different. That's not really a major label.
No. They're definitely a minor-ish label, but I mean, they're getting huge.
Yeah. But that would also probably be because their deal is better.
Yeah.
And they also local. They're very niche.
Very niche.
So they attract a certain kind of music, whereas like the major label would be like, oh, they have rap, country, electronic, reggae, whatever, everything, you know? Interesting.
Very interesting.
I don't know what I'd do if I had talent. Would I sign with a major label?
Probably.
Yeah, maybe. I had talent, though?
If you had talent, yeah.
If I didn't have talent, in a record label came to me and was like, we want to sign you to do covers of Dream songs, I'd be like, sign me up, baby.
Hell yeah,
let's
boy.
Let's go. Oh, my God, Dream.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.